ADS's tuning capability enables you to change one or more design parameter values and quickly see its effect on the output without re-simulating the entire design. While tuning can get you to a good starting point, ADS's optimization cockpit can further algorithmically produce the results that you want. In this video, we'll be using tuning and optimization to improve the performance of a fifth-order Chebychev high-pass filter. Here's the schematic of our filter. The filter is designed to have a cutoff frequency of 1 kHz. To simulate the circuit, we are performing a log-scale AC simulation across a range of frequencies. On the data display, we can see the characteristic fifth-order ripple, as well as the cutoff frequency. The main drawback of Chebychev filters is the ripple on the pass frequencies, and this video will focus on how we can minimize this ripple. We'll first look at how we can do manual tuning of the circuit. First, let's open up the tuning window. You can tune parameters of your component from this window by selecting the parameter. You can change the min, max, and step of the slider. As you slide the value up and down, you can see the data being re-simulated live. When you close out the tuning window, you can update the schematic to be the value of the slider, but I won't do that just yet. You can also add parameters to tune from the list of parameters, from Simulate, Simulation Variable Setup. We now see a list of all the tunable parameters for each of the components. I'll add R5 and R3. Note that there is a T bracket next to the resistor value. If I click on the value, we can see the full syntax for the tuning variable. If you are well versed in the syntax of the tuning functions, you can add tuning parameters from here as well. If you want to see the full syntax of this on all of your parameters, go to Options, Preferences, then the Component Text Wire Label tab, then change the format of the parameter. Back in our tuning window, we see that the parameters have now been added to our tuning variables. Unfortunately, there's only so much we can do with tuning. It can be frustrating to keep tweaking the values of the tune to try to get a certain result. A great solution to this problem is optimization using ADS's optimization cockpit. Navigate to the Optimization Statistics DOE palette and place a goal. The goal contains the limits that the optimization will try to reach. To decrease the size of the ripple, we want to both minimize the magnitude range of the ripple area and make sure that the cutoff frequency remains at 1 kHz. Both of these limits are related to the same expression, namely the magnitude of Vout, so we can place them in the same goal. If you have an optimization with multiple expressions, you can add additional goals. Let's try to make the limits reflect our goal. We'll evaluate the expression magnitude of Vout on the AC1 analysis. Since we're performing an AC simulation, we'll set the sweep variable to be frequency. Now we need to set the two limits we talked about. First, we'll try to decrease the size of the ripple. Ideally, it will have the value of 1 throughout the entirety of the pass frequencies, but we'll be more realistic and try to keep it inside of 0.95 and 1.05. We'll do this from 1.05 kHz all the way to 100 kHz. Which is essentially everything above our cutoff frequency. We also want to keep the cutoff frequency around 0.5 volts. We'll add a limit and keep the cutoff inside 0.4 and 0.6 at our cutoff frequency. Our goal is now set up for optimization. Before we can use the optimization cockpit, we have to add an optimization controller. Again, in the Optimization Statistics DOE palette, place the controller. There are a number of optimization types, which we don't have the time to discuss at the moment. In this case, we'll use a gradient type over 50 iterations. This means we'll stop our optimization after 50 attempts. Of course, the more attempts you take, the longer the simulation will take. The last thing we need to do is add parameters to optimize. There are two ways to do this. Let's activate R1 for optimization. Double-click the component, and then go to the optimization setup. Under status, set enabled. Here, you can set the minimum and maximum values. You can also have ADS automatically set up some minimum and maximum values for optimization from the simulation variables menu that we accessed earlier. Go to the Optimization tab and select all the parameters that you want to be included in the optimization. We now have optimization goals, an optimization controller, and optimization parameters. We are ready to run the cockpit. You can run it from the toolbar. The optimization controller will run until either the goals are reached or the cockpit runs out of iterations. If you don't reach your goals, the cockpit will produce the closest result. You can always revise your goals or add iterations if you don't reach your desired result. At any time, you can pause the simulation and tune variables manually to help out the optimization. We see that our goals have been reached. We can update the values of the schematic to reflect these new values. We have successfully reduced the ripple of this filter while preserving the cutoff frequency. Thank you for watching this Keysight ESOFT EDA tutorial. You can find a link to a free trial of ADS in the video description below.